Hi, welcome to another 5-minute tip. In this tip, we're going to look at the project spline tool, or just the project tool for short. It's a really useful tool for dealing with splines and uneven surfaces, or maybe even surfaces, but just ones at strange angles. Let's get started. Here I have a landscape, so I've just put some contour lines on it, there's a little bit of lighting here, and in general, the idea is that we want to run a pipeline along the land below this ridge. And then right here, we want to climb the ridge and go up and over. Sort of like a water pipeline or an oil pipeline. You get the idea. So the first thing we do is we draw our pipeline out. We sort of sketch it out. So typically, you'd use a linear spline for this. So we say our pipeline starts here, and I'm just going to keep bringing it along this ridge. Just clicking every few units, sort of imagining that there are sections of pipeline. And then we go up and over the ridge. I'm going to keep clicking. And you can see it sort of disappears as we go through the object. That's part of our problem. If we go back to the perspective view, we can see now that we do have our spline, but it's all flat. It's all on one plane. So the tip is, what if we could shove all the points down to the landscape so we can get our pipeline? So let's see how that would work. The project tool is accessed under the mesh spline menu. I'm just going to tear that menu off so we can see it. And it's right down here near chamfer and create outline. It's project. So it works with a selection or without a selection. So if I were to just select some of these points and then we choose project, we get a couple options. We can either choose a plane, or the view, or an axis, or spherical. So if we choose the view, it's going to project the points relative to the way we're looking at it. So if I were to look at it from this angle, and then just press apply, you can see all the points are now projected to the view space. So this is progress, but it's not exactly what we want. We want to project right from above, so that they go down to the surface of the land. To do this, we just select all or none of the points, and we choose project, and then we want to project it on the XZ, because notice Y is up, so XZ or ZX is the flat ground. So I can just choose XZ plane, apply, and then all of my spline's points go down as far as they can, and they sort of stick to the landscape. From here, you would simply create a sweep NURBS, and perhaps a circle as the cross section, and then place these two into your sweep NURBS and scale the circle down, and you get sort of a pipeline along the surface. Now, you could always translate it up on the y-axis a little bit, just to get it floating over the spots you want. And you could also select your spline, select all the points, and then use the chamfer tool to sort of round the corners a little bit. So there's a lot of different things you can do once you have this sorted out. But right there, we were able to sort of project the spline down to the surface so it sticks to the surface or hovers just above it at even distances. So that's one use of the tool. I'm just going to switch to another project here. Another use of this is to project text onto a curved surface. So I have a oil tank primitive and a number 5. The number 5 is made of a text spline object and a loft NURBS. So if we go to wireframe view, we can see that the geometry here is pretty regular, and I've done that. So just use a subdivided spline with a maximum length, sort of matching the tessellation that you want, and you can achieve this sort of effect. Now, once we have this, we're going to turn off the loft NURBS, because the geometry here will actually get in the way of the projection. It's kind of strange, but it happens. And we take our text object and press C to convert it to an editable object. Now, if we go to the point view, we see that we still have some large gaps here where there's no points. And that won't work, because this point will get projected down, and this point will get projected down, and then this line will just run through the surface. That's not what we want. So I can right-click this text object and say current state to object. Now, what that'll do is make another text object where all of the interpolated points are sort of created. That's the one we want. So I'm going to delete the first text object. And the second text object, with all or none of the points selected, I'm going to choose project. And I'm just going to use the view option in this case. So I want to make sure I'm looking at it at the right angle. And then I just press apply. And we can see that all of the points are now sticking to the surface. So we're almost there. We can turn our loft nerves back on, where we see we now have geometry on the surface. We can convert our loft nerves to an editable object. And then we can do whatever we want with the geometry. So in this case, I'm going to select all and extrude. And because the extrusion takes the angle of origin into account, we get a nice number 5 that is stuck to the surface like that. So we can select all and reverse the normals, and then change the Phong smoothing so it actually has an angle limit of about 60 degrees. And if we deselect everything, we can see we have a really good looking number 5 projected perfectly out of the surface. So I hope this tip was useful to you. The project spline can be pretty handy for creating effects like this, or in the case of our pipeline, creating effects like this, where you just, it saves you the work of having to place each point directly on the surface yourself. So until next time, see ya.